Polaroid Corporation was founded by Edwin Herbert Land in 1937. They produce instant cameras that print picture instantly after clicking the camera shutter. The study is about the issue between Polaroid Corporation and Shamrock Holdings. Shamrock acquired 5% share in Polaroid when the price is low. Polaroid seen as a company that most convenient to be takeover. Why? Polaroid recorded low profits, carried a small amount of debt, and owned huge amount of unliquidated assets of patent infringement suit against Kodak. Shamrock is one of the best contender for takeover. In 1988, Roy Disney and Stanley Gold of Shamrock started their bid. Approached McAllister Booth, the CEO of Polaroid, several times before Polaroid agreed to meet under certain conditions. A day before meeting Shamrock, Polaroid's board held a special meeting under short notice. The management proposed a comprehensive plan includes an employee stock ownership plan, ESOP, amounted 14% of Polaroid's share. The board agreed and the plan was announced while the meeting with Shamrock was cancelled. Shamrock didn't accept the Polaroid's decision well. The ESOP plans will spoil the bid. Shamrock claims the Polaroid's board breached their fiduciary duties in decision-making process. Shamrock continues to buy their shares for higher prices, but Polaroid rejected and continue with the comprehensive plan. Shamrock brought this matter to the court as a shareholder and their plan for takeover. Three questions that need to be answered in the conclusion of this study. The questions are, when director approved 14% ESOP, were they fully informed about the terms of the plan? For instance, did the board consider the effect of the ESOP would have a productivity or on the independence of the company? Did the board know how the company's employees felt about the plan? 2. Did the board have fiduciary duties to study about the plan? And 3. Did Polaroid adopt the ESOP primarily as a device to thwart Shamrock, or did the plan serve fundamental business purpose? There are 3 objectives of this study. They are 1. To discuss the effectiveness of board decision-making and the right of the directors to get sufficient information. 2. To discuss the duties and responsibilities of the board, whether they have performed related fiduciary duties to study about the plan. 3. To discuss the relationship and responsibilities between directors and shareholders and to identify whether there was a conflict of interest involved in the decision-making.
Section 211 of the Companies Act 2016 has elucidated that the board has discrete authorities and powers for managing the management of the company, and also can be seen as a governing body that sets policies for corporate management and oversight. Board play their roles in terms of promoting good corporate governance culture, oversight the management, and supervise the management performance. Pursuant to paragraph 1504 of Bursa Securities Listing Requirements, the Board of Directors has the rights to the resources upon their duties as directors. In addition, Section 215 of the Companies Act 2016 explained that the directors have their rights on relying on the information, professional or expert advisors, as well as seed resources in furtherance of their services as directors. Apart from that, Board of Directors need to be able to perform a good decision-making in order to sustain continuously development of the company in the long term. Pursuant to FRC guidance on board effectiveness, where it highlighted that the board can minimize the risk of poor decision-making by including the contribution of the committees and investing time in the design of their decision-making process and procedures. Therefore, directors shall make an effective board decision-making so that they can overcome any risks and challenges that arises or may occur in the long-term process. Firstly, the management need to provide sufficient information to the board and give a timely circulation of proper notice of meetings with agenda. For example, the management need to circulate the meeting materials such as notice and minutes of the meeting at least 5 business days in advance of the board meeting. Next, the board directors also need to describe in board papers on the process that has been used to arrive at and challenge the proposal prior to present it to the board. Furthermore, the management also need to dedicate some time for the directors to consider board papers and discuss on the strategic issues. Lastly, the chairman also need to ensure the presence of quorum before the meeting conducted so that each director can actively engage in pointing out their opinions, ideas and disagreement as well as contributing in the voting system. In the Polaroid and Shamrock case, the board of directors does not fully get their rights to get sufficient information upon the ESOP plan from the management. This is because the boards are not provided with sufficient meeting materials such as board agenda, board papers, minutes of meeting and notice. They only get notified through the short notice for 2 hours discussion. This leads to the hastily in making decisions among the directors, and the directors also were both misinformed and uninformed as to the material facts. Therefore, the board of the directors did not get their rights to get sufficient information regarding ESOP plan. In regards to the case, the Board of Directors of Polaroid Corporation did not practice the steps of effectiveness in decision-making. This is because the board has insufficient information since the management did not prepare the meeting materials in advance before the meeting started. The Board of Directors can only refer to the proposal that has been prepared by the Vice President, Harler, which is inadequate to make decisions. Next, they also could not describe and write appropriately in the board papers upon the process in achieving the final decision-making and challenge the proposal to be presented to the board. Moreover, the directors of Polaroid Corporation have only been given 2 hours on the implementation of ESOP plan in a meeting called at a short notice. This leads to a hastily and rush in making decision that can lead to damage after. Lastly, the chairman also did not ensure the presence of quorum as the 3 directors are absent in the meeting while 1 of the directors need to leave early before the voting system has started. So, in my opinion, the board of directors did not practice the steps of effectiveness in decision making that leads to less success on business strategic plan.
Firstly, Section 213, Subsection 1 covers on duty of good faith. This means that a director must act bona fide for what he considers to be in the best interest of the company and not for any collateral purpose. Therefore, the director must make sure that he does not in any way have any interest whatsoever in the act. Secondly, Section 213, Subsection 2 covers on duty of care, skill and diligence. For example, directors of companies are responsible to ensure the financial statements of the company are prepared and financial position of the company can be adequately explained and disclosed for auditing purpose. Therefore, a director should always ensure that the decision he makes are of the highest standard and for the best interest of the company. The directors whose fiduciary duties towards Polaroid and the management board has exercised their power and acted bona fide in the best interest of the company. This is because the board takes into consideration several factors, including Polaroid excellence, before implementing ESOP. Judge Berger stipulate, even though the 14% ESOP was not common among the employees, but it would be unlikely to harm the productivity of Polaroid, as it did not so extensive as to constitute gross negligence. However, the directors did not fully exercise reasonable care, skill and diligence as the management was only responding to the takeover threat. The arguments arose pertaining reallocation of 14% company's capital in a 2-hour meeting and 4 directors were absent are considered as making reasonably appropriate decision. Therefore, When it comes to making a business judgment, all directors must be participative to ensure the decision was made for a proper purpose and in the best interest of the company.
Let's move to the conflict of interest. So the bonding between an organization and directors creates a fiduciary duties. This is because the organization places trust and confidence in the directors. Therefore, it is really significant for the directors to act for the best interest of an organization. Next, a director also must not put himself into a position whereby a conflict between his duties to the organization and his personal interests might occur. A potential conflict that might arise is when a director receives gift, materials or benefit from the third party that have interrelated with the organization, either it is directly or indirectly. This is really important because it also have been mentioned and stipulated in Malaysian Company Act under Section 213, Subsection 2, whereby a director has duties to act with the reasonable care, skills and diligence. Apart from that, the directors really need to disclose the potential conflict to the organization if it happened to arise. This is because organization needs to be aware of the potential conflict arises as they can make a binding decision whether to authorize or not. However, if the potential conflict arises was not being disclosed properly, that means the directors had breached their fiduciary duties towards the organization. Hence, they need to be liable and take a full responsibilities for their action.
So in the case study, Shamrock agreed whether the decision of the board to approve the ESOP could not be protected by the business judgment rule because they have breached their fiduciary duties. This is proof that the conflict of interest exists between the shareholder and also the Polaroid management. Some shareholders are disadvantaged because of this decision, but there also have a great majority of shareholders that will get the benefit from it. So this is why the Polaroid Corporation may protect the interests of majority, even though they need to sacrifice their minority shareholders. So in the practical term, the management itself more inclined to fight over the takeover process because this process may result in loss of management earning, employment and so on. So by setting up the ESOP, the Polaroid management can improve their position in a few ways. Therefore, ESOP can effectively eliminate any hostile offer and maintain the operation by the current management. So, the Polaroid management saw that by setting up an ESOP and by sue Shamrock, they can improve their own position in the company.
As per conclusion, so all the main discussion questions have been clarified earlier. So when we see the board of director does not really receive full information regarding on the implementation of the ESOP plan. Besides, the director also have failed to practice an effective decision-making step in developing the decision. When we talk about the fiduciary duties, they only fulfill to act in bona fide. Unfortunately, they fail to act in reasonable care, diligence and skill, whereby the approval of the ESOP was only granted due to the takeover without knowing the management motive. And lastly, when we talk about the conflict of interest, yes, there is a risk of conflict of interest between the shareholders and also the directors in the making decision as they don't really communicate fairly to deliver the right information.